Excuse me, everybody, I think we've probably covered enough now on target audiences, and I think what I'd like to try and do now is move on. We're actually way ahead of time, so, you know, we'll finish early. I'd like to move on to objectives now. And again, I'm going to do a short PowerPoint to look at objectives. So with objectives, the idea is that you need to be very clear about what you want to try and achieve. Okay? It's so easy to rush in. One of the pitfalls of communication planning is that people rush into the process and don't go through this, if you like, rigorous, thought-provoking process that we're going through now. They rush in, and usually what they do is focus on the media. Oh, great idea, let's tell the fishermen about seagrass problems. And we're going to produce a poster. Produce the poster, spend a lot of money and time producing the poster. If the fishermen never look at the poster, the message is not targeted towards them. So it's really important to be very clear about what you want to achieve. And I think it's important to set yourself some objectives. So thinking about what is it you want to achieve, and we've talked about this already, you know, motivations, attitudes, behaviours. Do we want to develop skills amongst people? Is it about giving people knowledge? And you can see here some of the effects that you might want on people. Problem solving, just paying attention. So when you develop objectives, they need to be very, very clear about what we want to achieve, and what we use the acronym SMART, which is the objectives need to be specific, you know, exactly what do you want to happen. Have some measure so that at the end of, say, your communication process, you can go back and look at the objectives and evaluate whether you've achieved these. So you need to be able to measure what you're trying to implement. Is the action appropriate to the size of audience? Is it realistic? Do you really have a chance of achieving what you're setting out to do? And finally, again, going back to the importance of evaluation, is it something that you want to have within a certain time frame? So, for example, do you want 50% of the fishermen to monitor the seagrass in the next 5 years? Okay, so you set yourself a very specific target, and that helps you measure and evaluate whether you have actually achieved it. The other thing to do is if you're working within an agency, so park agents, your conservation or NGO, it's important that your communication objectives also fall within or are connected to your agency's goal. And if you're working on a specific project, your communication objectives need to fit and be compatible with those broader project objectives. So I always think it's important to think about there's three different kinds of objectives. You've got the learning objectives. What do you want your visitors or your audiences to know or learn as a result of your communication? Emotional ones, how do you want them to feel? And then finally, behavioral. Now, you might find with this particular issue that you're focusing on that you're only going to address one or two of these. You might have a learning and an emotional objective, or a behavioral objective. But it is important to think about these three different types of objectives. So just here's an example, and these ones haven't got a time frame on, but you could easily add them on. So a learning objective here, 80% of car drivers should be aware that public transport is better for the environment than driving within the next 10 years or 5 years. Emotional objective, 65% of visitors will leave the site with an increased appreciation for the Australian bush country and how it influences then the behavioural one, the example here is 75% of directors of extractive industries and 25% of medium-sized companies should integrate biodiversity issues into their business plans and missions, say, within the next 5 years. Okay, so those are some of the examples of objectives. So what I'd like you to do now is to think about these three different types of objectives, and so that you're very clear about what you're trying to achieve. So you can spend the next, say, 20 minutes working out some objectives. So you've got your issue, you've got your target audience, and now you need to develop some objectives. Yeah, sure.
And when you do this in reality, I'll be honest, I'm doing a dream exercise. You also have an indication, like, what do they know now? If I want to learn it. Because if you have knowledge, then you can formulate what you want to add to knowledge. Say, for how do you feel now about it? That makes your objective more realistic if you know what it is. That's why it's so important when you do this communication planning to do that actually somehow in dialogue with your audience. The more your users in your tool, the users are involved in the developing of the tool and in the distribution, the more you are sure that you are really going to be. So the more we know and we relate to it, we don't do this only behind our desks. Here we have a desk description, I want to say.
Yeah, in reality. I guess, yeah, it's about really knowing your audience, yeah. Knowing what, you know, makes them tick, what if, as, yeah, knowledge.
We gave all the examples how you find out that. So there's a type of focus. If you can, in your local community, have somebody from that target group sitting with you, that helps.
Yeah.
And that doesn't mean possible. Mm-hmm. It's time, as you said.
Yeah. Okay, so again, you can work together, and sometimes that's very helpful.
Yeah, I did.
range. So yes.
You were so Thank you.